The judge tells me, Mr. Kleck, would you please stand up? I stand up, and she goes, Mr. Kleck, I find you guilty. I'm like, what? Did that freak just say guilty? And right then, I went off to prison. Right there. I was like, what the fuck? Did that psychopath just say guilty? But the Lord put me in prison. I had a prison ministry. I was in there for, I had 2 concurrent 1-year sentences. And I was out in 30 days. The Lord got me out in 30 days.
Do you want to know what it's like to go to prison?
Have you always heard of a prison purse and wonder what it was?
Prison story time!
Come on, man. Are you serious? And no worse than these 2 guys that I'm getting ready to talk about in this video right here. These
prison
2
story
guys
time!
Might be the worst at it. This fucking tool right here, all up in your face.
Woo! Yeah, it feels good.
Woo!
Ric Flair.
You know what a fifi is? Subscribe to my Patreon, and I'll show you how to make a prison fifi. They made them when I was in there. I'll show you how it's done. Exclusively just for me. You won't get this information nowhere else.
Say it! You know what it is? Woo!
Anyway. As I was saying, these guys are super lame, right?
Well, Jeff Pesca, I've come to find out, gagged a guy, tied him up or duct taped him up, blindfolded him, and hauled him off and told him he was going to be sodomized. And he's saying that Richard's on the other team, like the bad guys.
And then I realized that he had stopped. That's when I started to get my restraints off,
What were your restraints exactly? What were they?
Gag me with a sock in my mouth. Gag me with a sock in my mouth.
The sock I thought was a nice touch.
Wrap me up in boots. Cover my eyes completely.
Oh, I got roughed up, man. Oh, blah, blah, blah. And then he plays this game that he's missing.
And I don't want to be happy about the cat video when something so serious is going on because apparently Richard is missing.
And then all of a sudden he pops up with this fucking video where he takes his fucking parcels out and paints a little bit of fucking makeup around his eyes.
World hip hop.
World star. World star hip hop. Thank you. You saved my... Bro, you saved my life.
Okay. Hashtag, I'm okay. Hashtag, Epstein didn't kill himself.
If you need any more proof that it's fake, just look at the hashtag at Epstein didn't kill himself.
It says, I just found out that Richard Montbleu is missing. Richard is missing. Here's a post from his sister. Please share. If anyone has heard from Rich recently, please contact me or April Montbleu Piper. Okay, then on Saturday, September 16th, police searched the home that my brother Richard Allen Montbleu rents in El Dorado Hills, California.
Oh my God, bro. I'm good. Listen, I'm good, guys. They let me go, I'm fine. I'm fine. I don't even know what the... Bro. I'm good. I don't even know where I'm at. I got like 17, oh my God. It's like 20 missed calls from my mom. I already sent my girlfriend my location. She's coming to pick me up. She's like two hours away. I don't even know where the... And it's like the whole mood... Hang on. The whole mood changed. It's like too much heat and they got spooked. And they let me go. We like came to a agreement. I'm not gonna snitch. I'm not gonna say who it was. Listen, guys, my girlfriend's coming. I'm just gonna like go back here or something. I don't even know if they're, what are they gonna change their mind or something? I don't know. But I'm okay. I'm gonna make a video. Oh my God. I'm gonna make a video tomorrow. I need some rest. I need to just go home and see my girlfriend and my cats and. I'm gonna make a beer tomorrow. I'm gonna tell you guys everything they did. And I'm fine now. I'm going home. She's coming to get me. But I promise, I'm telling you everything. I'm getting my revenge. I promise you, I'm getting my revenge.
I have been missing from YouTube for about 2 weeks now. So, real quick, allow me to play you a string of TikToks from my own personal TikTok channel that's going to tell a very wild story and kind of explain what's been happening.
I took over a black prison gang during my 10 years in prison. First, I survived my brutal initiation. I became a gangster disciple. A gang that started in Chicago, Chirac, is known for beefing with rappers such as Lil Durk and King Von. White guys were allowed to join back in the 70s when rival members ran into the shower to shank the founder of the Gangster Disciples, and this white cellmate ran in there after them and saved the founder's life. I quickly realized in prison, the number one rule is always remain useful. If you're not useful to anyone, you're useless to everyone. And if you become useful to the most powerful, dangerous people in there, you become powerful and dangerous. So what was I doing to become so valuable to these people? I can't tell you because it would be stupid for me to get on here and tell you what I was doing in prison. But let's just say by the end of it, I didn't even have to show up to these mandatory gang meetings. They would say, oh, let him go in his cell. He has stuff to do. It's so important. It benefits everybody. The violations when a member breaks a rule or a policy of the gang and they need to be physically punished, I didn't even have to participate in those because I couldn't be bothered. I was too valuable. Not to mention when I finally got free and came home, I had a very nice gift, probably as a thank you for everything I did for that gang.
Jeff Pesca. Jeff Pesca sent two envelopes. Jeff, if you're getting this, I very much would like to talk to you about the checks that you sent. I actually saved your envelope because I wanted to send you a thank you letter.
People in the comments on my one video have been hating the video where I said, told the truth about how I took over a black prison gang when I was in there for 10 years. All these comments, oh, big cap, he's capping, nah, cap, big cap, big crap, okay, because you don't know. So, and guess what? I talked to the fellas, you know, the fellas who I was in there with, and some that I wasn't in there with but are still apart. They're coming over today. Yeah, the fellas. They're coming over. We're going to talk. Everything's fine. We had a phone call. They're coming over. I got snacks. I'll get them on here to vouch. I'm hoping. I'm going to try to get a video with the guys, the gang. Get them on here and put all the crap and all the haters to rest. And listen, all you guys who hated, I want you to keep that same energy. Make sure you comment on that video the way you commented on the video saying big cap. Okay, make sure you comment and apologize to me. Apologize and admit you were wrong, but you won't. You won't. You won't. So, yeah, about an hour, me and the fellas teaming up, collab.
I'm sorry, and I apologize for the video I made saying that I took over a black prison gang when I was in prison. And I didn't take over. I didn't have any rank. I just joined, and I didn't really have any say-so over anything. I'm sorry. I apologize for the video. And I also apologize for anyone who I may have disrespected by saying that and making a video about that. I did not mean that. And please just know that I'm sorry and I apologize. And I'm not going to make any more videos about that. Also, I did not, and I'm no longer a member, so again, I apologize to everyone who is and everyone who felt disrespected.
I posted a video online apologizing for another video I made where I made things up about taking over a black prison gang. I want everyone to know that I'm okay. You don't need to reach out and don't be worried. I'm totally fine. Nothing has happened to me. There's nothing wrong with me, as you can see.
Hey everyone, it's Rich Moblo. I hope everyone's doing well. I just want to do a quick check-in video as a follow-up to my post the other day to let everybody know that I'm doing really well.
I'm totally fine. Nothing has happened to me. There's nothing wrong with me,
And I just wanted to say thanks to everybody. I've been going through the comment sections, just reading them individually. And I just wanted to say thank you for all your prayers over this ordeal. It has been quite an ordeal. And just reading the comments makes me feel loved. And I really appreciate all everyone's support through this ordeal, because that's what it was.
Also, if I do not post on social media, please don't let it worry you. I know that you may be worried, and thank you for reaching out. But right now, I may just take some time to think about the video I made and just make sure that I don't make any videos like that in the future that could possibly disrespect anyone in those videos. Thank you again, but you don't need to worry, and I promise I am totally fine.
As you can imagine, this has probably been one of the biggest trials of my life. And I was so grateful that the Lord allowed me to escape from the back of that truck, and that he sent Jonathan Kleck, Corey Barbie, Zach Wentz, and Billy, who are the people who are responsible for reaching out and actually securing my safety. So, Jonathan, guys, thank you so much.
Oh, my God, bro. I'm good. Listen, I'm good, guys. They let me go. I'm fine. I'm fine. I don't even know.